Well, folks, we are now just a little over a week away from the midterms, and the polls have once again shifted, and they've shifted in a way that should make everybody a little happy, right? Because according to the new polls, Politico Morning Consult poll, Democrats are once again back in the lead in the generic ballot polling by 5 points. According to the new generic ballot polling, which is where you go up and you ask somebody, hey, if you had to vote right now, it's a race, there's a Democrat, there's a Republican, no names involved, who do you vote for? 47% said, I vote for the Democrat. 42% said, I vote for the Republican. A 5-point advantage for the Democrats, which puts them roughly back where they were in early August, right? Coming off that summer of, you know, basically, well, and just off the Mar-a-Lago FBI visit. But the summer, we had all the January 6 hearings. Public sentiment against the Republicans was turning. So early August and pretty much all through August, Democrats had a healthy advantage in these generic ballot polls. September, things started to get a little fishy. Inflation was getting bad. Gas prices going back up. No hearings from the January 6 committee. Things went south. Republicans basically flipped it. And beginning in October, late September, early October, Republicans had a 4-point advantage over Democrats. But now here we are, late October, again, little more than a week away from the midterms, it's flipped back the other way again. Democrats hold the advantage. And what's the thing I always tell you when you're looking at these polls, right? You got to check the margin of error. Anything above 3% margin of error should not be trusted. This poll has a margin of error of 2. So it's a good poll. It's a reliable poll. That's a pretty good margin of error here. So what does this mean, right? Does it mean the Democrats are actually going to sweep the midterms? No. Does it mean they're going to retain control of the House? No. What we're seeing right now is some races are tightening, right? Fetterman versus Oz, very tight. Vance versus Tim Ryan, very tight. Walker Warnock, very tight. Marco Rubio now has a double-digit lead over Val Demings down here in Florida. She was just a point or two behind him a couple weeks ago. Ron Johnson has retaken the lead in his Senate race. You know, we've got problems. We've got lots of problems. So yes, this poll should make you feel a little bit better, but none of this matters if you don't go out there and vote. And I know Republicans have made it harder and harder and harder for Democrats to be able to vote. We just have to overwhelm them with numbers. And I know that sucks, and I know it's easy for me to say because it takes me 5 seconds in my tiny little county to go and vote, so I don't have to deal with these problems. But I'm telling you, if people show up, we can stop the bleeding. If the people show up in numbers enough to overcome the voter suppression, we can keep out Walker. We can keep out Oz. We can keep out Vance. We maybe even be able to kick out a couple other Republicans. That's what this poll is telling us. This poll's not telling us it's a guarantee. This poll is telling us if we show up, this is what could happen. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.